Let's look at part A of the problem we just described. So we have PRST is equal to PR times P of S given R times P of T given R. So if we were to draw a little diagram for R, S, and T, then we would say first there's R. Then from R, there's S. So R kind of tells you how to get S. And then from R, there's T. Okay, so once we have this, now we can answer our questions we posed before. Is S independent of T? And is S independent of T given R? So we'll start with the first question. How do we determine whether two things are independent? Well, we just write out the distribution and see if it factors. That is, see if we can write it as something that only depends on S times something that only depends on T. If we can, then one thing is PS, the other is PT. If it doesn't, then we know we can't. Okay, how do we compute the distribution of PST from PRST? We just have to sum over every possible value of R in the original. And this becomes sum over R. PR times PS given R times PT given R. And so for any particular values of S and T, we have to compute the sum over all R's. So every answer will look like a sum of however many possibilities there are different terms, and each one will have some S's and some T's. So in general, we will not be able to factor the result, because it'll be a sum of a bunch of different things that depend on S and T in different ways. So here we can't write, so this is not equal to PS times PT. So therefore, S and T are not independent. Okay, well, are they conditionally independent given R? Well, what do we have to do to compute that? We have to see whether PST given R is equal to P of S given R times P of T given R. How do we compute P of S and T given R from what we have, from this? Well, to compute a conditional distribution, remember that we just have to divide by the distribution of whatever we're conditioning on. So we take the joint, which we have up here, and we're going to divide it by the marginal distribution over the thing we're conditioning on. So PR. So this is PRST divided by PR. And when we write it out, we see that this just becomes PR times PS given R times PT given R divided by PR. Well, we can see right away that these two are going to cancel, leaving us with exactly the two terms we want, P of S given R times P of T given R. So the joint conditional distribution, the distribution of both condition on R, becomes the product of the two individual conditionals. It's the product of this and this. So since we can write this as a product, then they are in fact conditionally independent given R.